One of the most common questions I get asked is what tools and software do I use for creating and researching the books that I publish on Amazon? And in particular, what keyword research tools do I use? So I'm going to answer that by giving you the top five KDP keyword research tools that I use on a regular basis when doing the research for my books. Now, what is the aim of keyword research? Well, first thing is, it helps us find out what customers are actually searching for on Amazon, because a keyword is essentially the search term that customers type into the search bar when they're looking for something to buy. So we want to find out what that actually is. Then we use keyword research for finding the competition of a particular keyword, i.e. are there a lot of other publishers publishing the same book as the one we're planning on publishing ourselves? Then we can use it to look at the popularity of a particular keyword, so find out those search terms that are being searched for a lot. And at the end of the day, keyword research saves us a lot of time. Rather than just publishing a book using trial and error to see, you know, what may or may not sell, it helps give us that intel, that information in the first place, and save us a lot of time just messing about with books that are not even going to sell in the first place. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start off with the more simple keyword research tools that I use and work up towards the more complex tools. Now, when I say more complex, it just means that these tools give us more information. Now, I don't recommend you go out and buy or subscribe to all five tools at once. What I normally suggest doing, particularly if you're just starting out, is start off with the more basic tools and then slowly work your way up. As you become more experienced and as you start to make money, which you can then invest in some of these tools. So let's get into this. Now, the first tool that I actually use, which might be a surprise to some people, is not actually a tool at all. It's actually Amazon itself. But Amazon can give us a lot of important information if we know where to look. So the first place that we start is in the search bar on Amazon, and we put in a general search term that someone might be looking for, such as adult coloring book. And what Amazon gives us is all these suggestions here. And these are useful for two reasons. One, Amazon is telling us what people are actually searching for. And also, customers will tend to click on these suggestions, especially those suggestions towards the top. Now, what we can do is, once we get these suggestions, what I normally do is write them down in a spreadsheet and then start to put these suggestions into the search bar as well. So for instance, we could put in for women. And now you'll see that we start to get even more suggestions. So now we're getting more insight into what people are actually searching for. So you can build up a list of these suggestions. But another important feature of Amazon is that when we hit search, and the top left here, it will give us the number of search results. And here it says 30,000. That's a lot. It means there's a lot of competition for this particular search term. So it may be something that you don't want to use, or if you were maybe planning on running ads, it may be something you would consider. Now, I have done videos on how I do keyword research, particularly with this technique, which I'll leave a link to down below. And this particular tool using Amazon is ideal if you're starting out. It can give you a lot of information and insight into what people are searching for. When I started out, even though I'd done a lot of keyword research in the past when building websites, I didn't do any keyword research at all. And I used to watch videos where people say, oh, you know, it's the first thing I do. And I'm like, well, what are you actually doing? I don't quite understand it. And it really took me about 9 months to a year to really understand the importance of doing keyword research. So the next tool that I use is a Chrome plugin. And this is a plugin called AMZ Suggestion Expander. Now, this is a free plugin. And what it does is it gives us all these other suggestions here, which are also search terms that customers are typing into the search bar on Amazon. So it can save us a bit of time. Rather than going through all these suggestions that Amazon gives us, it can give us a lot more search terms, keywords as well. So it just means we can build a much bigger spreadsheet. Now, they do a paid version of this, which is AMZ Suggestion Expander Pro. And I find this useful for one main reason, and that is you can click on download keywords here, and it will download a spreadsheet of these keywords. And it gives us this information here, which is the approximate number of Google searches per month for a particular keyword. This is just useful to know, because if you find that a keyword does have a lot of Google searches per month, it can give that keyword a bit of extra strength, give it an indication that this is a popular keyword. And so we can get this list here of all keywords that people are searching for on Amazon. And if you click on these links here, it just opens that particular keyword in Amazon. So it can save you a bit of time if you are looking at the number of search results. So I find this very useful, bit of a time saver, and you can do this with the free version. You just don't get the opportunity to download all the keywords, but you can still get those keywords. Now, the second tool I use is also a Chrome plugin called Keywords Everywhere. Now, this is not a completely free tool. You do have to pay for search credits. Here, for 100,000 search credits, it's $1 a month, or I think you can just get the $12 billed annually. And I find that these credits last quite a long time. Now, if we click on the plugin, we can see we've got all these other features here, which I have to be honest, I haven't really looked to in great depth. And I've currently got 1,284 credits left. But what this tool does is when we do put in a keyword in the search bar, it gives us this information here, which is approximate number of Google searches per month, the cost per click on Google for advertising that keyword. This is their competition ranking. It appears to go from 0 to 1, with 1 being the highest. And also, if we hover over this graph, it gives us this little table here, which is the estimate of the number of Google searches per month by each month in the last 12 months. Okay, so now we come on to the more complex tools that gives us a bit more information. And there's one piece of information that is very, very useful, and that is knowing the actual number of searches per month on Amazon for a particular keyword. Now, in order to get this information, you do have to pay for it. You do have to pay for a tool or piece of software to get this information. And the first one we're going to look at is Publisher Rocket. Now, this is not free, but it is a one-off payment. There is no subscription, and it's currently $97. And what I like about this particular tool is that you're not overwhelmed with information. So you've got these other functions here like category search, competition analyzer, but what we're interested in here is the keyword search. So if we just put in adult coloring book, hit go get and rocket, we'll see here we've got this list of search terms or keywords. And what we can do is click on these magnifying glasses and get additional information. So this gives us all useful information: average number of pages in a book, number of competitors, average monthly earnings for books in these particular niches. But this is what I like, this information here, the estimated Amazon searches per month. We can get a good idea of the popularity of a keyword and not just relying on the Google searches per month, which is a sort of a roundabout way of looking at the popularity of a keyword. And from that, and from the number of competitors, this particular tool will also give a competitive score, 100 being the highest amount of competition. So as far as this tool goes, the one-off payment to get this information on the Amazon searches, I think is very valuable. And so we come on to the fifth and final tool, which is probably the tool that will give us the most information of all, and that is Helium 10. Now, this is subscription software, and it gives you access to all these tools. Now, the three main tools that I use are these ones here: Cerebro, Magnet, which I'll show you what those two do in a moment, and also the Keyword Tracker tool. What that does is it monitors the ranking of my books for particular keywords. And that's quite useful, because if you're wanting to make changes to your books, whether it's the cover, interior, your keywords, you can see how those changes affect the rankings of your books. Now, this tool isn't free, and it's subscription software. And so you can get the starter, which is $29 per month, gives you more limited access, but it does give you access to the important keyword research tools. I'm currently on the Platinum subscription, but if you were starting out, I would just go for the starter. And so here we have the Magnet keyword research tool. So let's put in adult coloring book again, get keywords. Now, what this tool does is it gives us a whole lot more keywords, which can be a good or bad thing, depending on where you are in your publishing career. But you can see here, for this one keyword, we've got 7,542 keywords. And for this, it gives us that important information, which is vital with these sorts of tools, and that is the search volume on Amazon. And also, it gives us the magnet IQ score, which is just the competition score. And in this case, the higher the number, the lower the competition. And basically, what it's doing is just conveying this information, the ratio of search volume to competing products, and providing that as a single overall score. And this box here, the word frequency, is also useful in terms of filling out the seven keyword boxes when you come to upload your book to the KDP platform, because you can use these individual words in your seven keyword boxes, and you know that these are popular keywords that people are actually searching for in relation to the overall adult coloring book keyword. Now, the next tool that I said I used was this, which is Cerebro. Now, this is what's called a reverse ASIN lookup tool. What does that do? Well, if we go over to Amazon, search for adult coloring book, take a look at one of these books, copy the ASIN, go back to Cerebro, paste that in, hit get keywords. It will give us insight into the keywords that this book is actually ranking for. So in effect, using this tool, we can steal the keywords that our competitors are using to rank on that first page of Amazon. So again, this is very useful indeed. And so you can see here, like adult coloring book spiral, although I don't think that was a spiral book, it's ranking at number one on that first page of Amazon. And you can see here from this organic rank list, you can see where it's organically ranking for all these particular keywords. So you can take these, do research on them, or maybe just use some of these keywords yourself in your book, in terms of naming your book, in terms of using them in the title, subtitle of your book, and using components of those keywords in the seven keyword boxes. So you get both of those tools when you do subscribe to Helium 10 and that keyword ranking tool as well, and access to some of these other tools, which I don't think are as useful for us KDP publishers. So my advice at the start, particularly if you are starting out on this publishing career, is keep it simple. Just start with the basic Amazon search bar, then maybe add in Keywords Everywhere or AMZ Suggestion Expander. And then after a bit of time, when you get used to using keywords, when you find that they're helping you get your books ranked, then start to use those tools that give you more information, like Publisher Rocket or Helium 10. What I would advise against doing is comparing the numbers you get from each keyword tool. So you may find Helium 10, maybe for adult coloring book, says there's 50,000 searches per month. You may find Publisher Rocket says there's 30,000 searches per month. And I get people coming to me going, oh yeah, one says this, one says the other, what's actually real? Well, they're probably both correct from the algorithm that they're using. But what I would suggest doing is not comparing the two figures, but instead comparing the figures within a particular tool. I think that's much more useful. So keep it simple. I wouldn't recommend getting all those tools at once. Work your way up as you get more experience and you start to earn more money. Now, if you are new to this KDP low content book publishing business, then what I suggest doing is starting with my book tutorials playlist here, where I go through all the steps of creating and publishing your first book on Amazon. I hope you found that useful. Thank you much for your time. It is very much appreciated. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button. And until next time, goodbye.